السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. May Allah bless you all. Today, inshallah, we are going to complete our lesson, which talk about mudud. The second part of mudud, which is substitute lengthening, or in Arabic, is called mad al-iwad. Okay. What is meant by substitute lengthening? Substitute lengthening, it means substituting a lengthened alif for the tanween with a fatah when stopping on it. And the lengthening is two counts, which means the length of two vowel and the same as the counts of natural lengthening. Do you remember natural lengthening or المد الطبيعي as the same thing? This mad take place whether there is an alif written after the letter or not. Like in word hudan, hudan. In word huda, how with tanween, how can we pronounce it when we stop on word hudan? Can we say hudan? No, that is wrong. We read it huda, huda. Okay? For example, nura wa huda, huda. We will replace tanween with alif. This alif is called mad al-iwad, and we make it as natural lengthening. In قوله تعالى ماءً, if we stop at word ماءً, we drop تنوين and add letter ألف. ماء. Okay, like that. That is called مد العوض. Okay, we continue reading and not stopping on the word that has the تنوين with فتح. This lengthening disappear, مد العوض. So pay attention here. We use مد العوض when we stop only. But when we continue reading in الوصل, we shouldn't make it. And the nun sakina rules are applied to the tanween. If there is an alif written after the tanween, it's dropped when we continue. Like هدى ونور in الوصل. هدى ونور. Okay, in الوقف or in when we stop it at word هدى, we drop تنوين and add letter ألف. So in recitation, we have two methods. If we continue reading, you have to keep or to apply rules of تنوين. Here in the following, هدى ونور. تنوين, okay, is followed by letter waw. So here we will apply hukm of idgham. Have idgham, okay, with ghunna. So we say huda wa nur, huda wa nur. You hear that? Okay. When we stop at word huda, we drop tanween and add letter alif. And in such a case, this hukm is called mad iwad. And we recite the word as lengthening mad with two count, two vowel count. Huda, huda, like that. Okay? Okay. The tanween is usually a sign of a noun, but there are two cases when verb have a tanween. So when you read that, you will surprise because you already know that the tanween is specialized for noun. But when you hear that we have two verbs or two words having tanween, you will surprise. So here there is a note. Tanween is usually a sign of noun, but there are two cases when verb have tanween on them representing the light not stressed emphatic noun, sorry, emphatic noon, and in this one is called noon التوكيد الخفيفة and not a part of noon. Okay, two places only in Holy Quran. The first one in Surah Yusuf عليه السلام in verse 32. وليكون من الصاغرين. Okay. And in Surah Al-Alaq, verse 15, لنسفعا بالناصية لنسفعا بالناصية. Okay, that is called verb. ليكون verb لنسفعا لنسفع verb. So we have here exception for verbs that we call the noon here is the noon توكيد الخفيفة. Okay. So the rule is the same when stopping on these two words. A two vowel count alif is substitute. So because maybe you ask yourself why we take this qaida here, but we talk about mad al-iwad or substitution lengthening. Because in two verbs, لنسفعَ وليكونَ, having the same alif or substitute alif when we stop at two verbs. So we should to talk about them. So the rule in is the same when stopping on these two words. A two vowel count alif is substituted for the tanween when stopping. لَنَسْفَعَ وَلِيَكُونَ. Okay. When continuing, these words are recited with tanween. The rules of tanween will be applied at al-wasl, okay, or at continuous of reading. But when we stop at the word, will we substitute the tanween with mad al-iwad or substitute alif? Also here we have exception. Not included in this mat is female ha in Arabic, which exists at the end of noun. This letter is always read as a ha sakina when stopping on the word, and is always read as a ta in the case of continuous. Okay, like for example, ni'matan, and make al-wasl as the following letter. But when we stop, we have to say ni'mah. Ni'mah. We drop tanween and pronounce ha. Okay, this is the exception. Okay. Now we are going to talk another type of mad, which is called mad al-badal or exchange lengthening. So the famous question, what is meant by exchange lengthening or mad al-badal? Okay, the letter, it means the letter hamza preceding any of the three mad letters, which are waw, alif, and ya, that is called mad al-badal. And the vowel of the mad letter is on the hamza, like wa'udhu, imanukum, adam, ilafihim. These examples were originally as follow. If you look at the word wa'udhu in the first one and in the second one, and imanukum, adam, and ila fihim, you will find two followed hamza. So that is called mad al-badal. Okay, more explanation to know what is meant by exchanging mad or exchanging lengthening. Since these words originally had two hamza, like in word uzu or imanuhum, two followed hamza. The first one had a vowel. I will read this one and show it for you again. Okay, the first one had a vowel and the second one has had sukun. The second hamza was changed into a mad letter from the category of the vowel of the first hamza. What does it mean? What is meant by change it into a mad letter with a category? For example, if the first hamza has kasra, then the second hamza change it to be ya. And if the first hamza has fatha, so the second hamza will change to be alif. And if the hamza has dhamma, the second hamza will change to be waw. So again, I will, okay, like that. Look at the last one. وأوزو, you will find that همزة contain ضمة and followed by همزة above واو. So we replace it or we exchange it to be from the same حركة. وأوزو, we drop this one and put the same حركة which is واو. Okay. In إيمانكم, you will find that همزة متحركة at the beginning of the word and then following another one, همزة on a chair, or in Arabic is called همزة على نبرة, okay, with the سكون. The first one is متحرك and the other one with the سكون. So the متحرك is كسرة, so we will drop the سكون or letter with سكون to replace it from the same category of كسرة, which is ياء. إيمانكم. And in Adam, the first one is متحرك with فتح, آ, آ. And the second همزة is سكون, so we drop سكون and replace it with the مد with the same category which preceding letter is فتح, so we say آدم إلى فيه إي إي كسر and the following one is سكون, so we drop سكون and replace it with the letter from the same category of the preceding one which is كسرة, so the suitable one is ياء. I hope you understand this point. Okay, مد البدل is lengthened for two vowel count by the way of recitation of حفص عن عاصم, the famous one. We have many recitation, but the famous one is حفص عن عاصم, which I explain the تجويد about حفص, recitation of حفص عن عاصم from the شاطبية way. Okay. We are going to stop here and inshallah I will complete the part three from Al-Mudud. I hope to study this part well and see you next time inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May Allah bless you all.